plot!
Get the mainstream!
Douse the royals! Talk!
Bring them up tight!
Ready to fire, sir?
Now's all but me! As much sand as you can!
Sheets tripped!
Larboard, come in! There's a man afloat there, sir!
Bully in the ash, way! Bully in the ash!
Awaiting orders!
Sally, girl that I love to
Loose topsails, gallants, and royals!
Ice dearly, bully dungeon, hold up.
Disappointment you are, Thatch. His mind's made up to stay, he says. It's a sodding. And hang all of you lot that follow this sorry bastard into obscurity.
I know you're come to call me home, Kenway. Your faith in me is kind. But with Nassau done in, I feel I'm finished.
I'm not of the same mind, mate. But I won't begrudge you the state of yours.
You still looking for that sage fellow?
Aye.
Taking a prize a month back, I heard a man named Roberts was working a slave ship called the Princess. Might want to see about it.
The Princess. Cheers, Thatch.
Well, don't sit there like a barrel of wet fish. We're celebrating my retirement! Uncork this man's breakfast!
Save us a few bottles, eh?
Think so, sir. But I reckon Kenway suspects something. He don't miss much.
Tell me about the beach.
A fair gathering, sir. Most too drunk to stand.
That will suit our purpose.
Tell me about Edward Peach. What sort of man is he?
Big fat, sir. At least that's what he calls himself.
But he's a mad bugger, he is. Cracked as a glass teapot, sir.
Detail. What problem is he?
Well, sir, he likes his drink, for instance. Only he makes him queer. He takes the usual rum with it, fills a half a weight of gunpowder to top it off.
Did I hear you were right? He drinks gunpowder? Did I hear you were right? He drinks gunpowder?
Aye, sir. just for show. And only last week, he rounded up a score of his crew and bade us sit in the hold of his ship while he burnt off sulfur and other sickening minerals. We just sat there like it was one of a million pits of hell and nothing less ordinary.
Good God! What the hell for?
Slightly cursed his crew is all. Tease out their fitness and what. Of course, it would have turned out he was the fittest of the lot. Thought for a moment I'd die there. Bloody savages.
Have no fear, soldier. This will be the end of them. Come on. It's time. Quickly, send a signal. And remember always this day.
What the devil?
Thank you. did he fall? Captain?
He drinks damnation.
Captain has the helm.
Thank you.
fast. So Thatch has been topped. Fuck's sake.
He was outnumbered. I couldn't reach him.
Devil damn the man, he was fierce, but his heart was divided.
It's hard to let go of the life you know best.
My own idiot father liked to brag about we meant to purchase a ship of his own. I'll get a privateering contract, Charlie. Your old dad'll be a captain. Drowned in a whiskey bottle before he ever left shore. Right, Kenway. I've been musing on this plan of yours. This observatory you're always going on about. How do we know it exists?
We find a slave ship called the Princess. Aboard should be a man called Roberts. He can lead us to it.
All them slavers work for the Royal African Company. Find one of their ships and start asking some questions.
Let out some sail!
What's our course, Captain?
We're looking for slave ships. Any that work for the Royal African Company.
You don't mean to traffic human cargo now, do you?
No, Jesus, Annie. You know me better than that. We're only after information. We'll find where the Princess docks in spare time.
The Princess? Slave ship?
Aye. Blackbeard told me there's a good chance we'd find the Sage aboard there.
We're clear, Captain!
Brace yourself for reason!
Captain! Vane just sunk a merchant schooner.
Damn! Can't that animal stay the course we agreed to?
Sir! Don't sink that slaver ship, can we? There's hundreds of innocent men aboard.
I know. I know.
She's booked, Captain! The slaver ship is running!
Damn fool! I'll get us in close.
Hold down!
Damn that Captain Bin! He's unloading everything he has!
He'll sink if he's not careful. We'll get closer.
Taking us close.
Louder than sticks and spittle, they.
I've more than enough of all that.
Just find the captain. This captain claims the princess sails out of Kingston every few months.
All right. We'll set a course.
You made ash of my sails and rigging, jackanapes. You owe me a share.
But damn it, Vane!
Oh, Charles, what a surly devil you are.
Don't fuck with me, Jack.
Oh, but it's my mandate to fuck with you, Charles. Lads! See, the boys and I had a bit of counsel while you were wasting time with this lot. And, well, they figured I'd be a fitter captain than you reckless dogs.
I'll cut you another cunt, Tracer!
This one I figure I might sell for a tenor down in Kingston, but with you two grog blossoms, I can't take any chances.
You regret this day, Rackham.
I regret most of them already. Tie them up! Cast them off.
I'll gut you, Jack Rackham! I'll open you up! I'll tear out your organs and strain your bloody luminance!
Stop your goddamn howling, Vane! There's no bloody use!
Well, well. The face of our good Kenway speaks, eh? Pray tell us, Captain, how to quit this predicament. And tell us what genius you have for sailing a boat with no sails and no rudder.
Shut your gob!
Keep still now. I'll take these oysters you've ordered.
You mad sap. This island's crawling with food, if only you'd care to look for it.
Yeah, I am looking, louse. Found some just here. Don't come following now. Do you hear me? Don't come looking for me.
Wretched fool.
Dance with the fishermen and their dories, Kenway! This island's mine! Come at me and I'll cap you, bastard! It was your bloody imagination that landed us here, Kenway! I'll be damned if I let that mind make one more decision for me!
Will you not talk to me, Vane? Are you fixed on this madness?
Madness? Nothing mad about a man fighting to survive, is there?
I mean you no harm, you corker. Now let's work this out like gentlemen.
Oh, God! I've got a bleeding headache on account of your jabbering. Now stay back and let me live in peace.
I would if you stop filching the food I gather and the water I find.
I'll stop nothing till you pay me back in blood. You was the reason we were out looking for slavers. And you was the reason...
Vane!
Man. I said not to follow!
Jesus, you've lost your head, man!
It's a fair exchange for finding these flintlocks and grenados.
Listen, Vane. We can hunt with those guns.
And I mean to! Bloody rags will be all that's left of you, Kenway! You into this mess, Kenway. And I'll be damned if I let you drag me into another.
You keep this up, and I'll have to kill you, Vane.
Bloody try, by all means. I see you coming, Kerr. I see you plain and clear. It's either you or me who's leaving this island alive, Welcher. Because I'm not going to sail again in a world cursed by your ugly boat. Escaping me!
goddamn fucking name, Vane!
Nancy boy, you're done half a fucking job.
Fucking hell. Is this my reward for believing the best about men? For thinking that a bilge rat like you could muster up some fucking sense once in a while? Maybe Horner Gold was right. Maybe the world does need men of ambition to stop the likes of you from mucking it all up.
Or maybe you just don't have the stones to live with no regrets.
Don't save me a spot in hell, Shankar. I ain't coming soon.
Stealing a fishing schooner single-handed. Damn canny, Captain.
As is taking back my brig from this pillock. Once again, I thank you both.
This Billy Huff didn't last 2 months with your ship before he came limping back to Nassau. Took the pardon straight away.
I had to, lads. That Rogers was onto me from the first.
Hold your tongue, Rackham.
So what now? Still chasing your elusive fortune?
Aye, and I'm close. I've heard the Sage is sailing out of Kingston on a ship called the Princess.
Put your ambition to better use, Kenway. Find the Sage with us.
I've no stomach for you and your mystics, Mary. I want a taste of the good life. An easy life.
No one honest has an easy life, Edward. And it's aching for one that causes the most pain. All right, Rackham. Back to retirement.
Drunken,
What news are they?
This Bajon works for the Royal African Company. Tell him what you told me.
I haven't seen the princess for 8 weeks or more. Meaning she may soon be back.
What else?
I thought this Buck belonged to the other men who was asking about the princess this morning. So I told him that...
What other men?
Hottie sailor in plain rags. And a gent with a scar just here.
Where have they got to?
Staying just round the corner, they said.
I grow tired of chasing these fantasies of yours, Edward. As does the crew.
Hang in there, man. We're getting close.
Have you alerted the men? We're short on time.
Aye. There'll be two soldiers waiting for us at the crossroads.
Very good.
If you don't mind me asking, sir, what's the meaning behind these blood samples we're taking?
Blood is required for the observatory to properly function.
How do you mean, sir?
If one wishes to use the observatory to, say, spy on King George, then one would require a drop of the king's blood to do so. Do you know?
Does Torres mean to spy on me, then? For I've just given him a sample of my blood.
As have I, Captain Hornigold, as will all Templars. It is a measure of assurance.
And trust, I reckon.
Yes, but fear not. Torres has shipped our sample to a Templar safe house in Rio de Janeiro. We will not be the observatory's first subject, I assure you.
Aye, sir. I suppose it's a small price to pay for what the Templars have given me in return.
Precisely.
Governor, when you hunted pirates in Madagascar, Jasker what methods work best. I believe it was my charisma that persuaded him.
Violence and threats should always be a last resort. In Madagascar, I offered those pirates a choice. Take a pardon and return to England penniless but free men, or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Just as you did in Nassau.
Precisely. A pity Commodore Chamberlain did not live to see my thorough success.
It's not like you blow, Rogers.
We all deserve a moment, don't we?
It's a bedlam!
Princess from these pirates.
Captain Hornigold has dispatched some of his best men to ensure the safety.
What of the state's present location?
Africa, Your Excellency.
Africa? By God. The winds are here.
I concur, Grandmaster. I should have sailed there myself. One of my slave galleys would be more than capable of making a swift journey.
Slave galley? Captain, I asked you to divest yourself of that Sikh institution.
I failed to see the difference between enslaving some men and all men. Our aim is to steer the entire course of civilization, is it not?
A body enslaved inspires the mind to live with more. But enslave a man's mind, and his body will follow off. Natural, efficient.
A fair point, Grandmaster.
Remind me, where in Africa are we looking?
Principe, sir. A small island.
We've sent two of our best men, Burgess and Cochrane. Privateers with fast ships and firm hearts.
Edward Kenway! Imagine my surprise at seeing your jackdaw anchored there. Have you heard all you came to hear? Will you now rescue the sage from our clutching hands?
A pox on you, traitor! You sold us downriver.
Because I found a better path. The Templars know order, discipline, structure. But you never could fathom these subtleties. Goodbye, old friend. You were a soldier once. when you fought for something real. Something beyond yourself.
Waiting order, sir!
Trim the yards!
What's our course, Captain?
Principe, quartermaster. We're sailing to the coast of Africa.
More of the dog, sir!
I'm off to find Roberts.
Don't stay long. The crew's getting restless.
Only what can carry maggots. We're not waiting on no one. Put the muscle in that bottle or we're leaving you behind.
You done us good, Kenway. Proved yourself a true bravo. And for what?
His own bloody pride.
You stepped in the path of my prize. Not a thing a man should do.
A cocksure, Cully. Just like Hornigold said.
That Templar scab means nothing to me. None of you do.
And you're worse for it, Kenway. It were the Templars who took us in when all else went to shit. Not our king. Not our country. The Templars.
The Templars is our family. Where's yours?
In honest service, there are thin commons, low wages and hard labor. Yet, as gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. So what man with a sensible mind would choose the former life, when the only hazard we pirates run is a sour look from those without strength or splendor? Ha! Now, I have been among you 6 weeks. And in that time, I have adopted your outlook as my own, and with so fierce a conviction that it may frighten you to see your passions reflected from me in so stark a light. But if it's a captain you see in me now, I then, I'll be your bloody captain. Yeah!
For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Oh. You fatten with your resistance.
I'm looking for the observatory. Folks say you're the only man that can find it.
Folks are correct. Despite my distaste for your eagerness, I see in you a touch of untested genius. I'm Bartholomew Roberts.
Edward. I've no secrets to share with you now. But if you'll lend me your aid, in 2 months' time west of the Leeward Islands, well, it's there you'll get some answers, I promise you. Funny that. With scurvy, the fix is more pleasant than the cause. When you catch a dose from a horn, must treat it with quicksilver. You're fonder of getting the disease than you are of curing it. Something biting at you.
Oh, all men desire to live by a code or a creed, yes? Yet when pressed, most defer to their instincts rather than the laws that bind them. What is the appeal of a creed if it does not yoke all men to like behavior?
Might make a man feel like he belongs to something. What's your answer?
Oh, that all men are sheep. That an old wolf like me deserves every ounce of blood he draws. Sail to this location. Bring only those you trust.